Hey, what's up, Terry? This is Devin from SEO Dallas, Texas. Thank you so much for clicking on this video. And I spoke to Valerie a little earlier, and I looked through my records. I actually spoke to Jessica a little while back too, so it's good to be able to connect with you guys again. Just really quickly, I'm going to show you three easy ways to beat your competition online starting today. You're probably wondering why I'm even making this video for you, and it's really simple. There are a lot of business owners out there that are spending all of their time running their business, taking care of their customers. They typically don't have the time to learn how to make the internet work for them and bring in more of those customers. Typically, the only thing holding them back from hiring a marketing agency is they just don't know who is an expert and who's not. So I found that by making these attack plans and just giving them away for free, a lot of these business owners still end up raising their hands and going, "You know what, Devin? I like you. Just take care of all this stuff for me." So, if at the end of this all you see I've got some tricks up my sleeve and I can really help you out with this business, just give me a call. We can chat. If you do want to take this information and apply it yourself, that's okay too. This is completely free education with no strings attached. I'm going to go over three quick things with you: how to make your website more of an authority, how to make your website more trustworthy, and then how to get yourself ranked in the local map pack rankings. So to start, let's look at your website. You have a great looking website here. It's very clean. It's very nice in the eyes. Really, really nice. Nice color schemes you got going on here. Really good. As far as content goes, to be considered an authority, Google wants you to have more content than your competitors because Google's whole goal is to put the best article in front of their users. So if someone types in plumbing in Lubbock, they want to look at the one guy who's going to answer all their questions. And so that's why I want you to have a bunch of content, because what Google does is they break your website down into text and they look at what keywords you have in your website. So like, if you see what keywords you're ranking for right now, you have 435. You're ranking for like plumbers in Lubbock TX. That's what people look up 350 times a month. So you want to rank that. Plumbers in Big Spring 100. Plumbers in plumbing in Lubbock 70. People click search for that. Plumber Lubbock 50. Lubbock plumbers 100. So you want to have all this content inside of your home page so they can rank you for that kind of stuff. Like this looks great. Now, to be considered an authority, Google wants you to have between 1,500 and 2,000 words. So let's see where you're sitting right now. You're sitting right about 1,000. So you're at a great start. I would just add on about 500 to 1,000 more on top of that. Your main competitors, you got jyplumbinghvac.com, J Young Plumbing, obviously. And if you look, they're not doing better than you with content. Content is king, and I'll show you why they're outranking you in a second. But by getting yourself up to that 1,500 and 2,000 words, you're going to really help secure yourself to be the number one person. So that's my first tip to you, is get yourself up to that 1,500 and 2,000 word mark. One last little quick little tidbit: whatever your images are saved as does count as content. So instead of saying this as AC1, you could save that as like HVAC Lubbock. You could save this as plumbers in Lubbock TX, stuff like that. All right. So that's my first tip to make yourself more authoritative. Now, being authoritative is not enough. You also have to be trustworthy. And to be trustworthy, Google looks at how many other websites are linking to your website, driving traffic to your website. But here's the thing: not all links are created equal. You get a lot more power from other plumbing companies linking to you than you would from like Pizza Hut linking to you, because Google knows you're not a pizza company. And so the tool I use to check this out, it's called Ahrefs. It does cost about $1,000 a month, but it gives you really valuable data on what's going on in the back end of websites. It says you've been around since April of 2016, at least with your website. And you've kind of steadily just gone up and down, kind of floated up and down, and you really ramped it up starting in July, adding a couple backlinks. Really, really great job. A lot of plumbers don't even have websites, let alone having websites that look as good as yours, let alone having even backlinks. So you're definitely miles above the pack. Let me show you up against, though. If you want to take out J Young Plumbing, they have 49 websites linking to them. So what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to dominate them. You don't want to just match them by getting like 35 more. I would say to get like 50 more or 75 more to completely blow them out of the water. And the best way to do that is just copy them. So go see what websites are linking to them and go get those same links for yourself. Easylocal.com, JY Plumbing, that's their own website. But toilet repair is going to be a good one. Heating is going to be a good one. Home improvement, air conditioning, heater repair, water heater, call a plumber, air con they have really good links. Cleaning service, water heater. These are really, really good links. I would go out and get for yourself. Okay. It's a lot more business for you too. They have about four times the amount of traffic coming to their site every single month. And you can even have more than that by targeting the correct keywords. But as you saw when I showed you earlier what kind of volume is out there, 350, 170. That's like with five keywords, you're already at 600 people. So that's that. My last tip for you is to be ranked in the most important part, because when somebody types in plumbers in Lubbock TX and they're ready to buy, they're gonna call the first plumber that shows up that seems trustworthy, and you obviously want to be that plumber because those are the easiest customers to close. Now, people skip these ads all the time. It could have been from bad experiences in the past, or they just have ad blockers. So where you want to rank yourself is in the Google My Business section, which is right here, or your local map pack rankings. And to get here requires having more citations than your competitors, which is anywhere where your name, address, and phone number are listed in different directories across the web. Directories being like Yelp, Yext, Yellow Pages, White Pages, Facebook, Angie's List, Home Advisor. These are really City Star or something like that. These are really common ones. The best strategy here is kind of like backlinks. Just copy whatever directories these guys are in, but then go put yourself in a bunch more. So like if Earl's Plumbing is sitting in 150 different directories, go put yourself in like 250, like maybe even 300 of them, just to blow them out of the water and hold that number one spot. So that is all I've got for you, Terry. I hope you found this really informative. As a really quick recap, to make your website more authoritative, you need more content with the proper keywords. To make yourself more trustworthy, you need to have more backlinks than your competitors. Just make sure they're relevant. They have to do with like plumbing and heating and air conditioning and stuff like that. And then to get yourself ranked right here in the Google My Business section, you need to be listed in more directories than your competitors. Just make sure that your name, your address, and your phone number are spelled the exact same way across the internet, so they're all considered relevant to each other. If you want to take this information and do it yourself, Terry, by all means, that's totally okay. This is free education. There's no strings attached whatsoever. I just ask that you please send me back some feedback as a response to this email. Just let me know if you thought this was valuable information. If you do want me to help you take care of this stuff, you can always email us back as well and just ask for some more information. Or give us a call down here. Our phone number is 214-441-6737. Either way, I do look forward to hearing from you pretty soon, Terry, and I appreciate you taking the time out of your busy day to watch this video. Thank you so much and have a great day. Bye.